Arturia. I don't know how to pronounce her name. But that company that I try to pronounce has just released, like at this literal moment, at the moment this video goes live, they have released their FX collection version 2. And they gave me early access so that I could, you know, make this video. So let's get started. So because I have early access, I do not have access to the website yet, but I do have access to my reviewer's guide. And from there, I can read a little bit about what the plugins are about. Now, what they call it is audio effects you'll actually use. That's a big claim because you have to first kick FabFilter out of my bundle because those are the effects that I actually use. And lately, I am using one Melda plugin, but I'm keeping that as a secret for now, which one that is. I think I hinted to watch it in some video, but you guys have to watch a lot of my videos to find that hint, actually. So they went from 15 plugins to 22 plugins, so that means that there are 7 new plugins. And those 7 are the Buzzforce, the Comp Diode 609, the EQ Citrol 295, the Chorus Dimension D, the Phaser Bitron, the Flanger BL20, and the Chorus June 6. So apart from the Force, that one I don't recognize, but maybe some people are now laughing at me. They're all based on analog devices, which makes it even more interesting because simulating analog, I still don't believe in it. I think I can fill about 10 videos with all the separated problems that developers face when they want to simulate an analog device. The more I get to know about it, the more I realize what we all do not know about what analog gear is actually doing. It's super interesting. Anyway, Diode 609. Of course, a 33609 Neve, and you can also see that in the picture. EQ Citrol 295. It's a Siemens Citrol. It's actually German, so you have to pronounce it in German. So that would be Siemens Citrol. Anyway, the 295. Wait, I have some kind of a 295. This is a 495, it's a 495B, and the interesting thing about those serial numbers is that if it has a 4 as the first number, it's a Neumann module, so of course this is from the Neumann, but there's also a 295, which is the Siemens variant, and for some modules there's also one with a 6, and the 6 was from, if I'm not mistaken, A&T or Telefunken. Anyway, all different brands, roughly the same EQ module, but they do sound different. Some have you know, different schematics or different ways of doing it or different quality of components and that kind of stuff. And most of the times the Siemens ones sound the best. So they are simulating the 295, which is the Siemens. Also, they do have a modern analyzer curve thing on top of it, which I highly appreciate because, again, we're controlling with a mouse. So yeah, and those three things are the ones that I want to take a look at today. So let's not ramble any further. Let's get into it because I'm pretty sure you also have more to do today. All right, let's get started with taking a look at the Citrol, the EQ. And that's the first one. So you can open this visualizer part by clicking visualizer. I'm trying to show you the full plugin here. So this is kind of interesting. Good thing is that it doesn't come with rust out of the box, which is always a good thing. I mean, imagine this. You're buying a plugin, you're paying whatever for it. I don't know what these ones are going to cost. No, I actually have no idea. But imagine you're paying for this, you're installing it, going through all the hassle, you're opening it, and it already has rust on it. I mean, if it's 40 years old, like if you already own it for 40 years and it's rusting, I mean, my Level Devil, that thing is also 40 years old or something. There's some rust on it. It's no problem. If something is new, you don't want to have rust on it. So it's pretty cool that these ones come out of the box or out of the installer without any rust on it. They are not screwed in. They are, I think, laying on some kind of table, some kind of plateau, which is also fine. There's one problem, of course, with laying down equipment on a table, and that is there are sometimes ventilation holes. And if the equipment doesn't have any feet, then it can get pretty hot in there. And the temperature is also important for your sound. Although some transistors actually want to be a bit warmer to get a good sound. You know how those things go. If you're really simulating it, when I put my hand on top of my monitor, I actually want to feel the heat coming out of it. Because 295, I don't think it's running very cool. Anyway, let's first take a look at this thing and then move on to the next one. Let's run the root through it. This is Sandstorm. Hi. Hi. Oh, so we have frequency switches on this one. And that's interesting. I don't know the original 295, but this one only has 14k, 10k, and 7k. And this one has 30k. Which is, you know, great for bats. And of course, it's not about the 30k, but it's about the shelf towards it. Can we also control it? Oh, we can't control it from here. So that would be a very good one to have controls in your spectrum so that you can, you know, control your analog gear through the means of like the computer, the mouse and the stuff. And yeah. Now I have to map it to my MP MIDI controller, of which I am one of the only ones that has it right now. Oh my god, I'm so poor. No, I know. But I'm thinking about all the people that are, you know, producing on a laptop. I have no problems over here. I mean, I'm not saying this for myself. I'm just trying to think in the patterns from people that are using it. Let's continue. Okay. Why does this sound so vintage? Why does this sound so... And if I do this with fab filters, like literally, oh, all right, this is it. There's no cream over it. But this filter... is very soft, very comforting. Huh? She sounds already a lot like the Neumann. Okay. I mean, the Neumann has a whole console around it, so there's you know, different colors as well. Presence. This is what these EQs are very good at, the mid-frequencies. I mean, listen to how silky those mids are. I don't know why. No clue. What's this range? Oh, this makes a step smaller, I think. Yeah, that's... very welcoming. You know, analog steps are always pretty big. Like if I look at this thing, it has, you know, steps of 2 decibels. Like the smallest step that I can take on my mid. Here, look at it. It's 2 decibels. Like that's the smallest step. I kind of do like half a decibel. It's not possible. So that's the cool thing about software. You can tweak it like everywhere where the analog counterpart falls short, which is also like control through this thing. But yeah, maybe that's not on there. Wishlist as much as it is on my wishlist. Let's move on to the next one. This one is, well, it looks very familiar. It's a Neve. It's just a Neve. It's a 33609. This one does come with a few pieces that could attract rust after, you know, a little bit of time. So, I mean, if you're truly simulating the analog gear, it should rust the longer you have the plugin installed. Yeah, makes a lot of sense to me. Because people care about that. That's just how the world works. I don't want the world to work like that, but it's how the world works. Different track from The Root, still the same title, Sandstorm. Wait a second, you cannot control the attack on the... on the 609 in the original, as far as I know. Yeah, Let's do only the drums. Like, it's a very, very, I think that's what fixed this. It fixes the original, I think. The 33609 has a very, you know, very own character when it comes to the way it attacks. I actually think the attack on the 609 is quicker than this. But it's cool that you can slow it down, of course. But then, you know, the attack is the thing that makes a 33609 a 33609. It's the fact that it attacks so snappy, I think. Because it's quick, but it's really, it gives a certain snap. Not getting that yet. Could also be that comes from the limiter. Let's see, because the limiter also has a very, very quick recovery or release. This is already more like it. Of course, here you can also switch that attack. Oh my god, this UI. It's, I mean... Here's one of those thing with those anamorphic user interfaces. My intuition says that I need to drag this down. So I'm clicking it and dragging it down. Doesn't work. I need to click in the middle and then it switches. Which is, you know... It's a small thing, but it hurts my brain a little bit. And I know there are a lot of people that trying to do personality analysis from my videos, from like what kind of disorder I have. Spoiler alert, I have been tested. I don't have any disorders. And I think if you're doing a personality test on me, maybe you should first get yourself tested. Anyway, these things are kind of confusing. Maybe that's because I'm using analog and I'm actually, you know, doing switching like this. That's why I'm trying to do this, but it's kind of confusing. And that's the thing, like, it looks so cool and it looks all, but it's just not kind of intuition. And also, like, if I use my scroll wheel here, this works, but if I use my scroll wheel here, nothing happens. Like, using the scroll wheel here makes even more sense than using it here, but because this is almost the same movement that I'm making with my finger, but instead I have to click in the middle. I know it's only a small thing, but we can all agree that it doesn't make a lot of sense. Another cool thing is that we can mix. Mix the original with the compressed signal. Let's do it like this. You can give it a little bit of swoon, a little bit of fill, or a little bit of. Yeah, you know what I mean. Okay, cool. So yeah, 33609 clone. It's not bad. There are already a lot of them out there. I mean, 609s, 1176s, all the caps. It would be very interesting to do a shootout video between all of them and really get to know them all. That's a lot of work, but there are possibilities. And the next job then is, of course, figuring out which ones there are. Like, not skipping any one of them. All right, the next one, it's not the Air Force, it's the Bus Force. Da 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 da! So, Bus Force, I mean, I like planes. I like planes more than I like buses. So, I know why it's called Bus Force, but it's like a little bit anticlimactic. Anyway, but Bus Force. Da da da! What do we have here? Equalizer, filter, compressor, saturation. Okay, we do have some overview here. Do a lot of knobs. They're shiny knobs, also a modern thing. Although, this already has some racking scratches here and here. Like, again, quality, guys, come on, it's a new product. People are paying for this. They do get a very nice wooden table as well. No, it's scratched. No, table is already scratched. No. Okay, let's go. Full song, yeah. Low. Oh, already clipping. Sorry. All right, so this is an EQ. So a 3-band EQ. But you can also use it as an effect. Can we? No, we can't control it from here. Oh, we do have Okay. Filter. Yeah, okay, Zed. Also, you can use... I think this is more of a... Is this more of an effect? Like a creative effect? Or is this mixing mastering? Anyway. Let's zero this. Filter. Yeah, okay, filter. Cool. All right, compressor. Whoa. That's all... Look at that ratio. Whoa. All right, that character is... It's already completely different from the 609. What's this? Oh, that's sidechain. No, not going sidechain today. Makeup gain a little bit. Would be cool if that would be automatic. Probably overlooking the knob. But automatic makeup is, I mean, we all know why. All right, and saturation. That's of course the whole force. Like saturation, that's what we want, overdrive. Oh, whoa. Makeup. So. It's not the most user-friendly, this stuff. It's not... Clipper. Ah, works the other way around. So we can drive it in there. Yeah, that's fun. This plugin looks the most serious, but it is the most fun to use this one. Like, there's most of the saturation, maybe the EQ also a little bit with like the very narrow this kind of stuff. Like, you can really create some funny effects that are quite usable. Although I'm not sure if that's the intention behind this plugin, because it's like it's set up pretty serious. So yeah, that's the quick test from me from the effects bundle. What I think, and this maybe is also a little bit of a point of a feedback towards Arturia. Like, you can see that they are spending a lot of time on their user interfaces. Now, I don't like skeuomorphic design in general. Like, why do I need a piece of wood on my screen? Why do I need the screw holes without any screws in them? Why do I need the knobs like this? Why do I need? I mean, they are putting a lot of time in that design. And what they are forgetting here is the user-friendliness. For instance, no automatic makeup gain compensation. And I mean, the Citrol has auto gain. Like, over here there's auto gain. But in the Busforce there's no auto gain. I mean, I couldn't find it. And that's already a user-friendliness thing. Like, it should almost be, you know, activated by default. And also, like I cannot really change my bands from here. Like, now I have to do this and this and... if you have it in here, I can already do two movements with, like, one click. Like, those kind of things are not in here. They really make quality products. Like, you can see that they do their best. They sound pretty good. I mean, you all have just heard the plugins. You can check them out yourself. But you have to use it in a production environment. You have to work and, you know, the client is waiting. That's why I'm using FabFilter. And that's a whole issue. And it's not just Arturia. Let's just be honest. It's not just Arturia. It's all over the industry. And right now I'm talking about Arturia. So yeah. Yeah, that's what I think. But apart from that, I do not think it's snake oil, because they are delivering. They are delivering a very good sound. If you need that sound, that's up to you to decide. Most definitely in this case, because these are all colors. And maybe you already have this sound, then you don't need it. But yeah, check it out. I'll link to them below. And I would love to hear what you guys think. Of course, maybe after testing it yourself. Maybe it's better to first test it and then come back to this video. And then post a comment underneath here what you think of these plugins. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm right. Let me know. Now, huge thanks to Arturia for giving me early access to this plugin. That's also the only thing that they gave me. They don't even get access to this video before I'm publishing it. That's how clean I try to keep things. If you like my independence and want to support that independence, then that is possible by, for instance, buying something through my affiliate link, which I'll link below. There's Toman and Sweetwater. And when you buy something after clicking that link in one of those shops, a little bit gets kicked back to me. And if we all do that, it ends up being enough to support this whole YouTube endeavor. Another way to support me is by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, and you get things like early access to videos and all that kind of stuff. Last way to support me and the whole YouTube platform is by watching more videos. So I'll link one of my own videos over there, but you can also watch something else around here on this page. Now don't forget to subscribe, keep pushing, and bye bye.